This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
No, the government's like this. The government, they don't want you to use your drugs. They want you to use their drugs. So every night on TV, you see a weird-ass drug commercial trying to get you hooked on some legal shit. And they just keep naming symptoms till they get one that you fucking got, okay? They don't even tell you what the pill does. You see a lady on a horse or a man in a tub. And they just keep naming symptoms. Are you depressed? Are you lonely? Do your teeth hurt? What the fuck? Oh shit, they got one. I got that. I'm sick. I need that pill.
Do you know the warning signs of osteoporosis? Unfortunately, there aren't any.
Oh my God, I have osteoporosis.
New rule, if you believe you need to take all the pills the pharmaceutical industry says you do, then you're already on drugs.
It is, it's just a big scam. 80% of all prescription drugs are unnecessary, repetitive, or prescribed only to counteract the effects of other drugs. Oh my God. You know, it's just, and who names these drugs? You know, it's like somebody's getting high at a Star Trek convention. I am Zocor.
Celebrex may increase the chance of heart attack or stroke, which can lead to death.
When taking Abilify, call your doctor if you have high fever, stiff muscles, and confusion, as these may be signs of a life-threatening reaction. In extreme cases, this can lead to coma or death. Coma or death. Death. Death.
Did that just say possible death? How are you going to put diarrhea and possible death in the same category? Western Mexico.
Diarrhea.
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 Some people may have nausea, vomiting, diarrhea.
Seek immediate medical help if you experience an erection lasting longer than 4 hours.
You know, that's why there's a drug problem, man. There's all those drug stores, right? Every 3 or 4 blocks, and that's a big sign.
Drugs.
Open all night.
Drugs.
We deliver.
Drugs.
Cut rate.
Drugs.
It's the biggest thing on their sign. Cosmetics. Sundries.
Drugs.
The weight of sadness. You may feel exhausted, hopeless, and anxious.
I have a job where I alphabetize insurance forms 45 hours a week, and I noticed I couldn't concentrate so well at my job, so my doctor put me on Adderall, and now I can just breeze through my workday. I don't even notice that my empty life is being pissed away underneath fluorescent tubes. I have no highs or lows. I have no good stories. But I'm getting a lot of stuff done. I'm probably the most boring person I know, but look at me produce. I just go A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, blah, 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 blah.
You gotta enjoy your motherfucking life. That's all the fuck I'm saying. Enjoy your goddamn life. Life is fucking short. Enjoy that shit. Some of y'all just need to smoke some weed and see if it don't help the quality of your motherfucking life. Well, why the fuck is it illegal? I don't know. Aspirin is perfectly legal, but if you take 13 of them motherfuckers, it'll be your last headache. Long as you've been living, you ain't never heard of a motherfucker overdose on marijuana. You might have thought that nigga was dead. He ain't dead. He gonna wake up in 30 minutes, hungry enough to eat up everything in your house. That's the side effect. Hungry, happy, sleepy. That's it.
Everything in our bodies is regulated by marijuana-like compounds that our bodies produce. So whether you're talking about the immune system, the nervous system, the digestive system, reproductive system, endocrine system, all of these coordinated body functions are regulated in a homeostatic manner by cannabinoids.
Until you know how Ambien CR will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Sleepwalking and eating or driving while not fully awake with amnesia for the event have been reported.
Congressman Patrick Kennedy was driving to work at 3 a.m. Why? Because he was on Ambien, which makes you crazy. And he thought he had to get up out of bed at 3 a.m. and go to work. But that's okay, because Ambien is a prescription drug.
Why would the pharmaceutical companies want you to be able to grow a plant in your backyard that might cure your menstrual cramps, might solve your headache, might give a terminally ill cancer patient some chance of gaining some weight and having a tiny quality of life? If you can grow that in your backyard, there's no net profit for corporations. We already know what net profit means to stock prices.
A spokeswoman for the Drug Free America Foundation, I'm sure she has a tremendous sense of humor, is pleased the doctors will no longer be writing marijuana prescriptions.
You can't have people going out and selling anything and everything and declaring it a medicine. I mean, where do you draw the line on it?
Where do you draw the line on it? I tend to draw the line at what my doctors think will work. Or I ask a spokeswoman for the Drug Free America. I feel them equally qualified when it comes to my health.
You have a group called the Partnership for a Drug-Free America. Well, first of all, of course, we don't have a Drug-Free America, never have, never will. But who are the funders? Who are the main funders, source of funding for the Partnership for a Drug-Free America, of all things? The tobacco industry and the alcohol industry. They are drugs. They are mind-altering, sometimes addicting drugs. Drug-Free America indeed. But why do they do that? They spend huge money to reinforce the distinction between legal drugs on the one hand and illegal drugs on the other.